All DJs know that some tracks are harder to mix than others. So for instance, some songs, when you play them together, especially for extended periods of time, they can sound terrible, and that makes people take the path of least resistance, and that is to mix on the outro, because when you mix on the outro, it's really safe, as it sounds clean, as there's nothing really but a clean beat to mix on. Now, 100%, mixing on the outro is a solid mix, and it's a really great place for new DJs to start, as it builds confidence and it also allows you to strengthen the mixing process to get used to like what song's playing and what you have to do. But once you've already got strong foundations, you're probably gonna get bored of mixing on the outro and you're gonna want to explore new ways to mix. So in this video, I'm gonna solve one of the most common problems that DJs face when mixing tracks, and that is, what if there is no clean place to do a mix? So for instance, perhaps the tracks that you're playing, maybe it has vocals the whole way through, or after the chorus, it goes straight into something, or perhaps you're playing really full-on genres and they just don't let up from start to finish, and it's just like, oh my God, where do I mix? And it just makes mixing and doing a pro-sounding mix really, really difficult. So let's jump in. I'm gonna give you a few examples of where people go wrong, how to fix it. Plus, once we know the concept, I'm gonna show you some ways to spice it up using effects. Okay, I'm gonna cover a few genres here, from tech house to drum and bass to techno to even pop music. So, okay, let's do it. I'll start with something fairly simple. Just got a track here, it's tech house, and I've gone and found where the chorus ends. So I put a cue point 16 bars earlier. That gives me a bit of time to beat match and come in over the end. But I'll show you, this is how a lot of people mix, and what they do is they're coming over the end of the chorus, and then once the chorus ends, they swap their basses. But let's see what happens if I do that, like, you know, for a song that just has singing the whole way through. Okay. Still a bit of basic EQ at the moment. So people go for their swap here and see what happens. One, two. Okay, see what I mean? So we've got here, listen. So I've got that. That's clean, that's great on its own. And I've got that. Happens all the time with vocal driven music, okay? But it does happen with some of the tech house too, that straight off the chorus, it goes into something. So see there, instead of actually doing the swap, to see the chorus ended, we went for the swap. You see now, this will start with EQ, then I'll start adding some effects. But what it's gonna mean is moving earlier on the bass, and then actually going early, so maybe even halfway through the phrase, maybe four bars left to go. You don't wanna go too early on the bass, because then you're cutting the chorus in half. You gotta be mindful, it's coming to the end of the chorus. And then what it is it's pulling that track back, okay, to create space for this one to come in. Let me show you. Okay. I'm keeping EQ fairly straightforward at the moment. So I come in over the end, coming in. Maybe I could peel back a little bit on the highs. And then four bars out, start swapping the bass. And then I like rounding in and out with the mid to create space. See how then something kicked in. If you're gonna mix like this and cut that out, right? All of a sudden, let's say that cut out and this went into an intro. It's gonna sound pretty kind of, you know, non-eventful. This is a bit more of an aggressive mix. So if we're gonna be aggressive and get that out, you do want something to happen. So for instance, if I went and did that from the intro, let's just go over this and what happens, the anti-climax that happens if nothing kicks in. Okay, we'll go this way for now. It's not bad, okay? But I thought before was better. You know, you come in with something strong. But anyway, keep that in mind. So all it was instead of swapping the bass on the one, moving a little bit early, and you've got to have that out by the one to create space for this one. Otherwise it gets messy. Okay, now even though in my course I dive into EQ mixing and give you a whole way of looking at the EQ, which will change your EQ usage forever. Like some of the videos I've got on the EQ, I think they're the best out there. Like I haven't seen anything like it. So I would suggest to DJs to get your EQ mixing down first. But then once you've done that, and by the way, what I mean by EQ mixing is sure I can give you like a framework, but then it's really about hearing the frequencies, but going in with a framework and then being flexible on based on what you're hearing, that's the kind of depth I go to in my course. But anyway, you get an idea here of the concepts and that's still really good. But once you've got your EQ mixing down, okay, then you can start looking at like using effects and that. So I could do the same concept here. I've got to have this one out by the one, but maybe I could add a little bit of filter, you know, maybe add a little bit of echo. I might go less on the EQ in this case, you know what I mean? Just so you're not looking at too many things at once. Personally, I'd be incorporating the EQ, I'd be incorporating the effects, I'd be doing all that together. But maybe I just keep it to bass swapping and just show you the effects side of things for now. So I'm coming in over the end. Okay, four bars out, maybe start doing this. Peeling back on the exiting, add some echo. Okay, this time I want to show you high pass filter without the echo. Now, using the bass and the high pass filter the way I'm about to, it's a really good way to kind of get out of a track. So let's say you're jamming and maybe you don't know what's happening and all of a sudden it comes in, you've got messy bit. You probably could just be bringing out the bass of the exiting song at high pass filter, and it's a really great way to exit. So let me show you that. But this song here, you wouldn't think it by looking at it, but this bit here, well, this is a chorus, but then, you know, that's rocking, and you just think like to mix here usually, right? But let's have a listen, and now it's kind of like goes into another verse, okay? And let's say I've put on this song, and maybe it hasn't even got the best response. Maybe I'm clearing the dance floor. Maybe I plan to play the whole thing coming out of the outro, but I'm like, oh geez, I need to mix a little bit sooner. So again, if I was mixing and then say something kicked in here, then that starts to kick back in. I've got two bits kicking back in together, and that's where this method's really good. Just delicious. I'd be doing EQ as well, but let's just focus on this for now. Oh, well, there's not a lot of high frequencies on this one anyway. Let's go early and see how I go like this. Okay. See, that's what I'm all about. Okay. A lot of people struggle with this, but nothing has to be hard. I like making, like you look at that and you're like, wow, that's easy. You know what I mean? It's about putting all this together, knowing when to do it. That's all the stuff I teach in my course. I know I'm plugging the course, but I love my course. I love what it's doing for people. But yeah, I just break down stuff that people think is hard, and really, it doesn't have to be. Okay, let's do a hard techno one. So the hard techno, sometimes you could have 8-minute tracks. So this is the same concept as replacing a drop. It's building up to the drop, get the other one out, bang. See, there's a space here. Go for it. Okay. Yeah, it's cool. Same kind of concept. It's all about getting it out, peeling this one back. This one, though, was lucky. It peeled back naturally. There's a space. If there's a space, maybe pull back on that space, bang. But then again, it is finding, say when replacing the drop, it is finding tracks that keep that same energy. If that really pulled back on the energy, maybe that'd be shit. But that's a pretty clean transition. Then I've gone into that, keeps it mixing, keeps things moving. It's actually pretty exciting. Okay, let's do a drum and bass example. So this song here, pretty much like, you know, pretty cool. And then, but here at the end, it drops off.
Okay, so like, I'm gonna go out.
You got vocals on vocals, okay? And let's say I put it on and, you know, in truth, I love this song. I probably would actually play the full song, but let's say you put on a song and it hasn't got the best response, or let's say with drum and bass, a lot of the time after the chorus, it might actually go into something, you know, or lots of genres do that. After the chorus, it just goes into something. So you want to mix, and you just want to mix a little bit quicker. So instead of going into something here, it goes into something here.
You can come back tonight if you want to.
Sometimes I like using the EQ. I can come in undetected. Start peeling it in. All taught him, of course. Okay, see, you got that. It's a little bit faster there. But it's pretty cool. You could do that same method, simplified a little, if that EQ moved a bit quick for you. I could just do bass, and maybe in the past we're doing the high pass filter. Maybe I could try the low pass filter for the out one. Let's give it a shot. Yeah, they're both cool, man. Like, you really, it's not about learning one technique. It's about learning one technique at a time, then putting it all together. Know you special, girl, cause I know too many. Risha, do you love me? Are you riding? Okay, so now let's do a pop R&B example. Now, just in my course, I know it's not a plug-in, but I'm just really trying to get you to a place that you can really achieve your goals this year. And I know that the course comes through in a big way. And instead of having different courses for different genres, it's all in actually the one package. So in the advanced performance part of the course, there's actually like three courses. Well, there's lots of courses within that course, but there's like one specifically for mixing vocal-driven music with it, which is pop, R&B, hip-hop, any stuff with a singing the whole way through. There's a whole section on the deeper kinds of house, which is all melodic house and techno, progressive techno, how to mix all those genres. And then like a heavier styles of dance, which is, you know, your drum and bass, like hard style, anything that's kind of like, you know, go in the old days, EDM, I guess, if it falls into that. It's all about, that stuff's more about energy mixing. All that stuff is in the course. And to be honest, I'm all about pretty much having the number one DJ course in the world where everything follows the perfect sequence, not clicking back and forth between courses. One course to rule them all. Anyway, it's nice to have goals and to work towards that. A lot of people think it's already there, but anyway, enough of me and the course. Okay, let's try this. So same kind of concept here. It's just singing the whole way through. I know you special, girl, because I know too many. Risha, do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me, because I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always, JT. Do you love me? So this is what you need to take from this video. If you're DJing and the tracks you are mixing have singing the whole way through, or you're playing heavier genres and neither track gives you a place to do a clean mix, then making the transition time where you play both tracks together needs to be shorter. Otherwise, it's gonna get messy very, very quickly. Now, it's still the same concept as your other basic transitions, but you have to move early on the EQ. And instead of swapping the basses and emphasizing on the one, which is like what most people do, it's about rolling out that exiting track early with advanced EQ methods. But you've also got to keep phrasing in mind, and you want to, like, you know, so the phrase drops out, your new track kicks in, and, you know, it's beautiful. Now, I personally love mixing like this, and if I'm not sure what a track is doing and I intuitively feel that the master track's not going to let up, and let's say I just want to play it safe, then 100% right, this faster style of transition, It's awesome and allows me to pretty much mix wherever I want, as long as you keep the overall phrasing in mind and not upset the flow and the energy of the mix too much. See, at the end of the day, it is all about the flow and how people respond to your music on the dance floor. Anyway, I am just scratching the surface here, and this content is starting to get a little bit closer to what's offered in my course, but the course does have a much more organized approach, and the structure of the course, you know, it assures that you're taught what you need to know at the right time. So if you're new and this is over your head, trust me, right, I can get you there. And let's say you're a veteran DJ and you already know a lot of stuff, but trust me, it's always good to look at familiar topics in new ways. And I can assure you by the end of the Club Ready DJ course, you're going to be more than like, you're going to be very, very confident. I'm seeing reviews from my students all the time. You're going to be at a place that even if you've got no intention of playing in the club, you're going to be ready to, you know, and trust me, you'll want to. You might not see that now. You might think, I want to learn to DJ, but trust me, once you know you've got the confidence that comes post-course, you're going to be really ready. I'm really proud of the course. It is my baby. I know I'm plugging it, but you know, I am giving you free content. So it's a bit of a give and take there. But anyway, thanks again for tuning in. If you haven't subbed already, get some good karma. Send me some love, you know, it inspires me to keep making videos for you. It's going to be a big year. I'm really feeling the year of the dragon vibe. So let's buckle up.